And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
It's The Bonfire, Lost Tapes, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I am Dan Soder. That is Big J. Okerson. I'm pointing with my eyes. Joining us, it's an acoustic bonfire. That means no studio.
That's right. This is awesome. We've never done this.
Yeah, we're doing a bonfire from Jay's apartment. And joining us, the bully boy himself, old BB Shane Gillis.
Yo,
Shane,
what's good? Gill. What the fuck is good, dude? What's up, Denny's?
If you were,
what the fuck is up, Denny's?
What the fuck is up, Denny's?
What's up?
Oh, you got iced coffee? Coming in hot, dude.
I got a little bit of iced coffee.
Might have to ask for
this
a sip.
This is great. I have a Sixers playoff cup, commemorative cup with my iced tea.
I'm just in a fucking crouch position like I'm catching.
No, lean back. Enjoy the cloud.
You want me to Fat Joe it?
I want you to enjoy the cloud. Move the green bag.
No.
Act like an adult.
I like laying down like
you're
a
like
latch.
Biggie,
it's weird. What you're doing is weird. It's not what it's meant to do.
Dude, this is why
Biggie
we can't.
The money, more problems video.
That's what I always say to Jay, why I can't lay down, because immediately I get like Biggie. I'm just like, no, it's like my man Puffy said.
But you're choosing to lay down.
Well, I can't just sit down. I like this.
Stand up and go back in it, buddy.
I like being ready.
Stand.
Feel the thing.
Stand in the place. If I stand, I'll feel like I'm giving a weird
picture. You're destroying everything that makes it the cloud and not enjoying it. It's making it worse for you.
I like this.
You want me to sit there? You want to sit here?
Stop it.
Do you want Shane to show you how to sit in the chair?
How do you sit down? Can you guys show me how to sit?
You want me to show you how to fucking
sit in the chair?
Can you save the last dance with me? But
what are you, feral?
Yeah.
We can't teach you.
You go, get inside, Dan. He just won't stay inside. You give up on me? We got to take him back. He can't. My mom gave a dog back. We adopted a dog named George.
That's hilarious.
And then she gave him back.
You named him George?
My mom did.
Love giving dogs fucking just
human names.
Human.
Like we had a dog named Bob, and we had to put him down because he went after my friend Nick Myers.
I told you when me and my dad went, and he tried to drop a dog off at a little kid's baseball game and run away.
What?
And we
what?
Got the car?
No, I've never
Come
heard
on.
That story, dude. I've never.
Come on.
What?
Dude, he had a dog. The dog was, it was cute, but it was like, listen, I'm not like a real big pets guy for the responsibility.
Oh, it's my wolf night.
I like the cutesy of it.
Yeah.
I really do. But the responsibility, it was just too much for
it's
me.
It's a lot.
For me personally.
If I didn't,
much.
If my mom did most of the heavy lifting a majority of my life with Montana until I was a teenager, and then I could feed him, but she'd walk him every morning.
Uh-huh.
My mom would like do the things that.
I think my dad thought when I went there that summer that I was going to somehow like take care of the dog, that I'm like, I don't want to take care of it. I didn't ask for a dog. I'm not a kid's been asking for a dog or anything.
So he just gave you a dog?
Gave it. They just got
what
a
kind?
Dog.
What I kind think. Of
and
dog
it
was,
like,
was
it? And I think he got under the guise of like, well, I'll start off taking care of it because I'm coming up for that summer when he just got it. And the dog was awful. And it was
what kind of dog?
Just a mutt? Terrier of some sort. Yeah.
Terriers can go bad quick.
Yeah. Well,
high energy.
It was. Yeah. And
they're like speed backs.
And my dad's plan was we took the dog to a park.
Yeah.
And he started to. He was telling me what he was doing. I
How old were you when he's telling you this?
13,
okay.
12, right. 13.
You're not like innocent, like, why are we going to the park with it?
No,
like,
no, I didn't say innocently. No, and here's the thing, if it makes sense,
I'm saying that
I wasn't emotionally attached to the dog, really, but he was like, we're getting rid of the dog. But I definitely remember thinking and not saying, it's my dad, so I remember not challenging, though,
yeah,
and thinking in my head, I'm like, I don't know if you can just do that.
You know what's funny about that?
I'm like,
that's such a common way to think, though, as a kid when your parents do something and you're like, I don't think you're supposed to do it like
they're
this.
They're the parent, I guess.
But you run shit.
Yeah. So you're like, what is my saying anything going to do? But and also because in my mind, I'm like, I don't know, just give it back to like wherever you got it from and someone else who can love it will take it.
Wait, because this is where I got it.
How do you get rid of it?
I wouldn't abuse an animal ever. It's just like I would just reluctantly be taking care of one.
How do you get rid of this fucking thing?
So his plan was to go drop it off at this baseball game happening in a park, and he's like, someone will take the dog and
dude,
whatever.
What?
And dude, he puts it there, and then he's like, me and him, like when the dog like runs off and does whatever, like I don't even know. It would be funniest, I don't know, but there's some way that it had to be where there was like, the dog had to be distracted, so I don't know if he like winged something
dude,
and have the
ball, so
and,
funny.
And he jumped back in the
he
van.
He brings a real meat bone to the park, and he goes, you want to see your old man throw something? Just fucking, you're like, dude, dad put it on a rope. Just put that, on. That dog was like, what? I got it.
Dude,
I got it. I got it.
Dude, he fucking locked cannon.
Yeah.
He
hits the
nipples. Go long, dog. Yeah. I'm going to tattoo you.
He just
Bam!
Your dad doesn't realize how good of a gun he has and hits the center fielder that's playing.
Yeah. Michael Vick side the dog starts attacking the guy who catches it.
Like, time out.
Interception.
Yeah. Dude, so he just do that. Yeah, I mean, the fact that you guys try to run away from a dog at a park.
So we get in the car.
I'm sorry. How long did you own the dog before this?
I'll argue like under 2 months.
All right. Still fucking insane.
Absolutely. Yeah.
But
buddy,
if this was like year four, I'd be like, damn, that's ruthless.
Yeah, you know what?
Two months is still.
If it was year four,
you were raised by it. Your father's.
And by the way,
Shay,
keep in mind that could be anywhere, maybe like 2 weeks or something.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't remember. I have a very limited memory of it.
Day two is nuts.
So we go and we get in the car, and I remember him just like.
Pretty
Backing
cool, huh?
Out of a spot.
That was fucking crazy. We gotta go.
Because you want to know something funny? That's how I got rid of you.
Dude.
Did you see that trick?
It's true.
Yeah, he goes, I left you and your mom at a baseball
park.
Game.
I goes, you guys want to go to the carnival?
He
goes like this. He goes,
you get a head start. Go ahead. I'll race you there.
I'm on a roundup. Yeah. You know the roundup that goes where you're stuck against the wall and it goes up. It goes like tilts in the air. And I see my dad in the parking lot in the car. Every time you go around, he goes,
your dad's back.
Looks like my dad.
Your dad's back.
Oh, shit.
Your dad's back.
Where's he going?
Your dad's checking behind him going, and the cat's in the cradle. And the there you go. All right. He's got one of the drop shifts.
I see my mom holding cotton candy right in front of the ride going like this. I see my dad getting
Hey, Tare, why don't you take the kid on one of those things that sucks him against the wall? I'm going to go get a pack of smokes.
I'm going to grab some smokes.
You can't pull that pack of smokes.
Did he? What did he?
Do you know if he left for smokes, what my dad smoked would have made it so funny? Because my dad left to go get a pack of cools.
Yeah.
A pack of cool Filter Kings.
I'll tell you this. If your dad leaves you to go get a Juul, just kill your whole family.
Oh, yeah.
Your family is pans.
Yeah. They're like, my dad went to go get a Juul, never came back.
A Juul? My dad went to go get a cartridge.
Yeah. My dad, that's the new country songs. Dad left to get a Juul and never came
back.
They
were out whenever
I smell steamy mint vanilla.
Yeah.
It makes me cry and think of him.
You know, the smell of
fucking
kiwi.
Fucking vape flavors.
The smell of kiwi banana always makes me think my dad's about to walk around the corner.
Chocolate candy apple now just makes me shit my pants. Like, it's so
sad. You guys ever had guava cinnamon?
Impossible smells. Just set you off. Did your dad left? He was going to get a cartridge.
I can't smell
oh my
neon
God.
Pear. Yeah, Dad, I don't even know why that smells like something.
Cucumber aloe.
Yeah.
Kale.
Papa? Dad? Oh, is someone wearing
is
cucumber melon?
Oh, no, it's a guy with a curly mustache riding a unicycle.
Oh, it's a guy. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, dude. That's so your dad.
Lemon parsnip.
your dad's just at the park. Does he have you get in the car first? I would feel too much that I would have to lag behind for the dog.
So here's the thing. It was a pretty slow pull off because somewhere in himself he has a soul. It's a super slow pull off because as you look in the rearview mirror, the dog just comes to the middle of the street. Is in the pose of like. You know, extended front arms and the butts on the ground and looking at us just going like, why are they leaving?
Oh.
Those are people who are supposed to love me.
Oh,
oh no,
and,
dude.
And then I eventually...
This is such a bummer.
And then I eventually went, I was like, Dad... And he goes, he's like, we got to go back again. I'm like, oh, yeah, man.
Dude,
we got to go back.
That was going to severely.
And I think a friend of theirs, like, adopted the dog.
That was going to severely affect the way I looked at your father from then on. Like,
dude,
you told me
the fact that he went for it at first, though, was pretty great.
I mean, but still, it's like.
Well, dude, Metzger released cats into the wild.
Yeah, but that's Metzger.
And those are cats.
Yeah.
Cats are born, they're made to live outside.
Not in the woods of Toms River, New Jersey, man.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah,
no,
dude.
They're
we
not.
Let, my mom, we
you
let,
can let a cat out.
We had a cat.
To fight a raccoon?
Yes.
You're an idiot.
Dude, I had a cat that we let out.
You don't know what an outdoor cat is?
Sure, but they don't survive long because they're
they
so domesticated.
Yeah, true. I had one for a month that made it in November.
A month.
Central PA.
Dude,
that's a good month.
My cat Garfield mostly stayed outside. When you brought him in, he was just in there to get some warmth.
I have an outside cat right now.
Yeah, he was
at my
dick.
Parents' house.
Garfield was a straight up dick.
Tibble.
That's why I don't like cats.
You don't like them.
Don't care for them.
So if people were just throwing cats into a fucking wood chipper.
Oh no, I care about that. That's ridiculous.
You just don't like them.
I don't prefer them. They're not my preferable animal.
Sophie's choice right now. Dog and cat are hanging off a
dog.
Cliff.
I'll pick
dog
the dog
every time.
All day.
No, but the one that you don't save, you have to be the one to step on their paws.
All right, fucking put it down.
You're gonna kill that cat
for that dog?
Wow. Yeah, you
have
to.
This is for
wow
my dog.
Well, what kind of dog?
How do we have? Is it? Is it? How do we have a job on
shitty
on
Chihuahua?
Is it a tea? Is a teacup Chihuahua? Because I'll let that bitch go. I'll let that go for a fat tabby any day.
Yeah.
No.
Yes.
Yeah. Fat tabby.
How about a bitchy Siamese or a fucking like a very angry like lived with black people trained for dog fighting Doberman?
A Mike Vick Dobe?
Yeah.
An MVB? An MVD?
Yeah. A Mike Vick Dobe?
I'm saving the cat. It's a fucked up dog.
Yeah, the dog needs to die.
But what if it never lost?
Well,
obviously.
Yeah. What if you should maybe
get ready to
celebrate?
Then get ready to get studded.
Yeah.
I'm lining up feral bitches for you.
Oh, we
got to
breed this motherfucker.
Yeah, I'm going to find a way.
I'm going to have some alley cats for you to fucking plow.
Yeah.
I don't care what you put your seed in, dude, as long as it's half you.
They go, Dan, there is a dilapidated chihuahua in there. And I go, we're going to see what kind of mix that gets with old Zeus.
Yeah. What if it's the cutest dog in the world and like a kind of cute cat?
Later, cat.
But
meow, you got nine lives.
The dog is an anti-Semite. But adorable.
So it's a German Shepherd.
But I mean an active anti-Semite. Like will actually lead like
yeah,
violence.
And how cute's the cat? Pretty approachable.
The cat's like your run of the mill, you know, the bunch of colors no one gives a fuck about.
You know what? With
kind
my pets,
the one that no one gets from a pet store.
With
you
my pets,
found it in a parking lot.
I don't want to know their politics. So goodbye, dog.
The dog goes.
If a cat even says maybe that it's got a preferred pronoun, I might let that cat go. I don't know. I'm stuck in a real goes, jam.
I identify as they.
Yeah, I go. All right.
Riggins was racist.
Do you know
your dog was?
Riggins was a racist dog.
Dogs are pretty racist.
I bring over my
dogs
friend
are the most racist animal.
You bark
oh, buddy, we brought my buddy Justin came over a friend's house one day that had a my friend as my friend Glenn's girlfriend's house, and. Certainly not racist, at least the kids that we know, the people we were friends with, you know what I mean? But they used to have a, what do you call it, St. Bernard?
Yeah.
In their house that I literally thought was a statue most of the time. It never moved. We brought my buddy Justin in one time. Justin was a, Justin was black. And
you hear that bassy voice?
No. I mean, bit him in the stomach.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
It was a thing, yeah. It was a fucking thing. I was like,
but I bet how firm were his abs that the teeth didn't go in?
I'm telling you, that my point only being,
was
like,
muscular?
There's no way
why
to
are you
even,
assuming he was muscular?
There's no way hot you can even dude disparage. Are you guys having a gay moment? Should I step out? You want to leave the room?
Yeah, hop out for a second.
There's no way to argue that dog wasn't racist. I mean,
and the dog never moved besides
that. I mean, that dog never moved. You couldn't love it to move. Do you know what I mean? You could make it move from love and affection.
But bringing a black guy.
I mean, it lunged. It was like Cujo, dude. Like his rabies just kicked in.
Which makes you think.
It was crazy.
Which makes you think his parents are doing some racism that you're not seeing. That is.
For two reasons that dog should have been put down. For his beliefs and because you can't bite people.
You know, the dog that bit me, they didn't put down. And then it bit another kid like 3 years later. And you're like,
they put it down then?
Yeah.
After that one?
Yeah.
You weren't worth it?
I wasn't worth it.
That's the best way to look at
it. Also,
it bit Dan.
It bit my
of
face.
Of course.
It bit my face. And it bit the
it bit the other guy's toe.
Me.
His knee.
Done.
He coughs himself from a Neosporin. You had to get surgery.
Oh, dude, I had to get 46 stitches on my face.
What? That's not your original face.
Yeah.
You had 46 stitches in your face?
Yeah, I got bit right here, and then it went all the way down to there, and then I had a chunk right there.
Pipple?
Husky Chow Mix. Husky
they took his old face,
yeah,
and they put it on they put it on who you know now as Nicolas Cage.
Yeah, I go, Nick Cage, I want Dan Soder's six-year-old face on my face.
I took Dan's face.
He goes, Dan.
Off.
Take that child's face.
Oh. Yeah, that's uncut. Racist dogs are uncut. Like, my friend Jamal was just sitting there, and Riggins was afraid of him, but kept coming at him and barking.
What?
And then everybody would be like, chill. And then he would come back into the living room and bark at him and run away. He was running away from him.
But friend Jamal looks at your dad like, what's up?
Well, no, everybody knows. The dog had just never seen a black person. He was like
that's
1 year old.
Say,
yeah, he never saw a black guy.
Do you think it's something? And that's there's no way that
confused.
There's no way that was the case at my friend's house because we had a ton of black friends going on. You know what I mean? Like
so he just didn't like your friend for specific reasons.
No, I'm just saying maybe...
Was he wearing cross-cut colors?
Listen, maybe he was the first... No, maybe there's just been a problem before, but I would have to guess.
Yeah, because you can't train him to... You can't, like...
I was going
to
say, well, impossible. I guess you could, but I mean, like, that's my point. I was almost... That's
Trust
the question.
Me, I've been trying for years. It's tough.
It's the question I was going to ask, though. Is there any way it's inherent... It has to be taught behavior, no? Yeah,
I think it's...
I don't think it's taught behavior as much as it's when they see someone else.
I don't think Maria Bowe's when they see something different. Teaching a dog race. You know what I mean? Like they were
no, they just
nice
see
family.
Something different and attack it.
Yeah, maybe.
That's what it is.
It's got to be.
That means the dogs think they're white people. They're like, this is the pack I'm always with. I guess that happens to people, too.
Yeah. That's how racist you were seeing it through the eyes of a dog. It's like that dog story about racism.
Yeah.
Dog's way home. I need you to be racist, dog. And the dogs are hark.
Pitbulls are always angry of unfair treatment with the police.
Yeah, I think. Oh, police love killing pit bulls, which they do. But German shepherds? Do you think German shepherds were
inherently?
And no, but like with Jewish people, you're saying it's different. So with black people, you're saying
true
because they don't see their skin color. Jewish people have the same color skin as German people.
I don't think
I know. I've been school-tized it most of my life.
I know, dude. You've been
my last name's not Jewish. I've been sliding in.
Yeah, yeah, I wrote it on the mirror.
No one knows you're letting a Jew in your house.
I wrote it on the mirror in Sirius, and no one responded.
That'd be great if you go to the comedy store where it's like Jew, go home, and, everyone, and I wait outside in the rain.
Yeah.
Coward.
And then Natterman goes, "Scoot over. It's my turn too." Yeah, and then Lenny Marcus goes,
"I went
hey,
in on this.
Hey,
I'll fight these sons of bitches."
Most of the lineup.
Yeah, most of the lineup comes out. Entertainment. The president of show business.
Yeah.
What's happening?
Oh, why are we outside?
Who said what to who?
Who wrote that?
Jew, go home.
What?
I am home.
I own the place. It's the home.
It's my home.
Yeah, dogs.
Well, with Jews, I'm sure they could tell. The dogs can also sense who's being dominated. So, like, if you have a dude who's, like, in those pajamas and he's, like, 100 pounds and you're, like, yelling at him, the dog's like, yeah, fuck him. Yeah, so fuck this weak pussy.
So you're saying dogs are total front runners?
Dogs are bandwagons? dude.
All dogs
bandwagon.
Are fucking Patriots fans now. No
I like them.
Live.
I'm a Tom Brady guy. Wherever he goes, it's like people that say they're like
I don't
LeBron.
Care. I go where the fun is.
I like LeBron.
I follow LeBron. Where he
dogs,
goes, I go.
Dogs are NBA hoes. They show up at All-Star Weekend. Like, I'm trying to get a baby. I'm trying to get a warm bone.
Shows up with 8 jerseys with different teams in case whoever they fuck.
Just a bunch
I brought you a jersey.
Man, that fucking park story is sticking with me.
Is it?
That dog sitting there when you're driving away?
Yeah. It was the saddest thing I've ever seen
in
my life.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, that's rough, dude.
And I held a dying baby alien.
What?
Yeah.
What?
And that was the saddest thing I've ever saw was that dog in the rearview mirror.
Tell us the story.
No,
Clear Clop.
He evaporated into light.
He became.
It was pretty dope.
And then I learned everything that's already happened.
And then
I'm a three-eyed raven. I'm the three-eyed raven.
Yeah, so now he said it was a chosen one or something. I don't know. He said it'll. I'll know when it happens.
Dude, that's fucking just that dog in your rearview mirror going like, guys. Guys,
dude, it didn't even look like panic.
I know we don't
like
each other,
dude, it didn't even look like panic. It looked like, it was like head cocked.
Dude,
just like are you guys leaving?
What if you found out he was a dick? He goes, I bet it was the fat kid didn't want to run me.
Oh, he's right.
So you go, Dad,
fat kid
leave
didn't
him.
Want to walk me.
You go, Dad, leave him. That's where you got. You go, he's out. He's fucking
the fat
gone.
Kid didn't want to walk me. I guess I gotta be left in a park now because the fat kid didn't want to walk me.
Cool.
You can use a walk, you tub of shit.
He goes, good job. His original, he knows his real name. He goes, good job, bingo.
He's looking who's talking now, me.
Yeah. He goes, yeah. Now you're stuck in this park because that fucking kid didn't want to walk you. That dad's don't worry, I have a feeling that dad's out in a couple years.
I'm telling the story that way because I'd like to believe it was me making the first peep of acknowledgement. But my dad was stopping the matter. I mean, when I said, I think it's when it almost went like, I was like, Dad, he was like, yeah.
Dude, I'll tell you this.
He turned right around. Yeah. I was like, what are we doing? Like,
Trish taking George back was pretty cold-blooded.
Taking him back?
He just didn't mesh well with her program. So she took him back to the Denver Dumb Friends League.
The Denver what?
Dumb Friends League.
What's that?
That's how you where you adopt all your dogs.
They call your animals your dumb friends.
Really?
Yeah, it's called the Denver Dumb Friends League.
Is it? Is this a real thing?
Yeah.
It's actually called the Dumb Friends League?
I'm going to get a hoodie that says it.
That's a fucking cool team.
It's like the Kike Anti-Defamation.
Hold on. I'm going to look it up. Denver Dumb Friends League. Yeah, what is it called? It was not called the Pound. Denver Dumb Friends League.
It's hilarious.
The Dumb Friends League adopt a dog.
You want to come get an idiot you got to take care of all the time?
Hey, you want a silly brain?
Hey, do you not have a debilitated grandfather you have to take care of 24/7? Do you want to feel like you do? Come get a floppy-eared idiot. All he has to offer you is something to sit next to you.
That's a good cat. I would save that cat over some dogs.
All he offers you is something
that's
to keep warm next to your cold, lonely body.
That's a handsome boy.
That's a handsome boy. Look at that. Huh? Look at these guys.
He's a handsome boy. I don't like the top dog. I'd save the cat over that fucking gay dog. Long-haired dogs are gay. You can write that down.
Look at all these cats. You get a horse.
Put
dude.
That in my fucking
you get a
bio.
Big dick horse.
You get a horse. Horse girls, dude. We were watching TikTok videos like anime last night.
Dude, I got high as shit.
You got high as fuck. I drank a six pack. We were watching like fucking anime teens dancing. We were both like, Don't turn it yet. We watched it for a while.
So he started watching these things. He was like, yeah, there's these
called TikTok.
TikTok videos. And there's, bring it up on your TV.
If you YouTube TikTok cringe, dude, you're going to be like, what TikTok the fuck cringe. Is that?
Bring it up on your TV.
What is it?
It's hard to explain, but
like
I was so
anime.
Ripped. But anyways, we started talking about, it was like horse girls. We were talking about, you know, like, well, first off, we watched this movie called 12 Strong, which is one of the movies.
Oh, my God.
You watched that?
Yeah, dude.
Chris Hemsworth?
It's so bad.
I assume.
It's great. They use every war.
What's it about?
12 hot dudes that ride
12 horsemen coming to give the Taliban what for after 9/11.
It's a revenge movie.
We were talking though about fucking how funny is it that because you know the Taliban on 9/12 had to be like they literally had to be like deer for the next like week like they know it was us. Are they coming? Where the fuck are they, dude? Yeah. I know they're gonna be pissed.
Yeah, but someone this is the videos we were watching last night.
Oh, that's the video. I love her, too. Every one of these girls.
What are they for?
I have no idea.
It's only for guys.
Kids.
Yeah, I think it's like for
it's not for jacking, but it's getting you going.
No, it's for jacking.
Now, you start to jack to this, but then, you know, you find some porn.
Well, you find some porn of this.
Yeah, of this.
But what if you're a Vanilla Dan of the world of jerking to this? You
true.
Might be able to come to this.
This is definitely.
I can come to this.
I can't come to this.
I could.
No, not that. I bet you couldn't. I bet you couldn't. I believe
you could. Easy.
No, I couldn't at all.
Yeah.
I couldn't. The ridiculousness would make me not come.
That's what it was. We started down like a weird wormhole of watching these TikTok videos. And yeah, I can jerk to that.
You can?
I said I couldn't.
Oh.
But
if I there's it. Some. You toss in a decent, toss in a young lady.
So there was a couple hot girls where you're like, oh, well, we just kept, you know, it's like a YouTube wormhole. Where you just watch one video, then something pops up, and you're like, well, what's this? And you keep going to where it got to the point where it started being the Old Country Road song.
Yeah.
That's what it was. It was hot girls do, like dressing up like cowgirls and dancing. Mm-hmm. And then it turned into weird anime TikTok videos.
Mm.
What was Patient Zero?
He was like, oh, you want to watch some weird shit on YouTube?
Oh, I showed him TikTok cringe compilations.
It's people like, it's pretty fucking.
Can you read the comments?
On the YouTube videos?
No, I'm saying like, do comments run as the videos are happening?
Oh, no. It's not like that. It's like.
Great.
It's an app. Do you know, you don't know what TikTok is, right?
No.
It's an app where it's like you get to lip sync. No, it's like you lip sync to like movie lines or like it's mostly like cosplaying fucking weirdos.
You could do music, you could do dub smash. It's like that dub smash thing where you do like movie lines and you lip sync it. But there's some real. There's one guy that's so heartbreaking, and then there's one that's hilarious.
It's TikTok or TOK that one. But if you do just cringe, TikTok cringe is pretty great.
TikTok cringe is the one you have to see because you have to see this one guy who's. And again, we'll tweet it out at the Bonfire SXM.
So it's not always just hot girls doing it.
No. It starts as weirdos.
Yeah.
And then we fell into this weird hole of like, what's this anime one? And they're like, TikTok.
What it is? You know what it's like? It's chick, when they find a place where losers are gathering.
Oh my God.
Hot chicks go in and go for the kill on making money off
of it. You know what that is? That's their compliment pond. It's like them finding fresh water and they're like.
I mean.
Listen, aside from completely dishonoring your family. Tell me how awesome it is that you can make thousands of dollars a week just playing with your sniz on a computer.
Dude, if I could just beat around my floppy dick.
Could you imagine?
I mean, I'm
Dan,
sure
you
we
could.
Oh,
Dan,
dude,
you definitely
on a
could.
Gay website,
yeah?
Dude, you would fucking kill it, bro.
You see
Dan,
Tony
you're so
you're
hot.
Big, huge, fat hog.
Dan,
and
you have a huge
tan face. Oh, oh,
yes.
Oh, dude, you could beat.
Let me see.
Flex your chest.
I was doing that. Oh,
everyone's gonna be going like, "Oh my god, that guy's
that's not your grip.
The thumb doesn't touch the forefinger. The thumb doesn't touch the forefinger. He can't get it all the way around. Oh, it's a thicky. Oh, it's a
thicky."
And
then I gargle over cum. I go blah blah blah. Like a school volcano.
Is that the one you feel bad for already, Dan? The one with the leopard print hoodie?
No.
All of these people.
Oh, here it is. Well, I didn't see this one.
Turn the volume up.
I have these people. It's just chaos. How fucking crazy these people are. And it's all like weird sexuality.
Dabbing.
It's all like weird anime furries.
Oh, yeah.
Ugliest people you've ever seen.
Yeah, even garbage bags leak, baby.
Oh, they're just, they're
baby girl. Hot Indian dudes being hot. Hilarious.
Oh, my lord.
Dude, how great is this?
This guy's like Brazilian. I like this.
There's always been a faction of
exactly
girls
like
that are... I have a question. Pause it for 1 second. It's so funny, the change. There's got to be a change in every woman. And Christine, is this a good thing to say? Like, the softness of, like, that Indian kid that was just on the screen, right?
Yeah.
Like, young girls probably think he's, like, that guy's hot or something. And we look at it as so, like, girly.
Yeah.
But there's some correlation to that they just don't know anything else. You know what I mean? Like facial hair or something doesn't even make sense to a young girl to love that.
Well, you don't need facial hair to be attractive.
No, you definitely don't need facial hair to be attractive. I'm not saying that.
Yeah, Shane.
I'm talking about
you're a handsome boy,
oh, yeah,
Shane.
No,
Shane,
sure.
You're a handsome boy.
But you're also not a fucking, like alopecia bald baby face. Do you know what I mean?
I'm not far off.
Sure you are.
I mean, his cheeks are a wreck. You can go a mustache and a fucking goatee.
My mustache is nice.
Nice.
Comes people, in. You liked it. Don't look at me like that. You liked it.
Your swashbuckler comes in well.
Yeah.
Cheeks and chin.
Cheeks and chin, not great.
Yowzers. Listen, I'm fucking, I'm medium hair Dan. I can't go long hair. I can't get to Jay's. Jay's is awesome. That's a beard.
Stop it.
Jay, your beard is awesome.
Come kiss us.
Come on, guys. Stop.
Your beard's awesome.
Guys, let's spring break 99 this. Triple kiss.
Oh. Damn, what if we were easily manipulated like the girls in, like, Girls Gone Wild? Like, if some dude just came out of the camera and was like, you guys should kiss. And we're like, what? Yeah. This is crazy.
Oh, my God. ASU forever.
This is crazy.
Like, if we
show
were
us your dick. It's Mardi Gras. You go, no, I'm not going to. And then they have their plant coming in.
Couple
and
drinks. Like,
I'm fucking flapping. Dude. I'll fucking flap my dick, too. I don't care.
Elephant truck.
A bunch of dudes spinning dicks on a fucking bar.
Christine, can you throw those Snapples in the fridge?
Yes.
Damn.
Have them chill.
I'd get
Snapple heavies.
Fright.
Snapple heavies.
You going to
Snapple originals.
Ooh.
I would get hard stage fright if we were all showing dong.
Oh, yeah,
I
dude,
get that.
If it was just me, if there was 100 of us, I'm getting stage fright right now. My dick's crawling up.
You got a full tenus going.
Yeah, full tenus.
Got a tiny little
I don't like it.
Well, that's why your
I'm
dick.
I'm all tucked.
That's why your dick can never be a Marine. It doesn't run towards the action.
It does. Some people run away.
Some people run away. The Marines.
My fucking dick's a deserter.
Yeah. I'm done. I'm out.
My dick's goes. How big's your dick? It's like AWOL.
AWOL size.
It's AWOL. Snuck off in the middle of the night.
I want to see how this girl finishes this dance because she's like,
oh, I bet you
know. Y'all, shut up.
Yeah, this girl is clearly in high school.
Yeah, throw the spank bank, dude. Get in there.
Not at all. What?
There's an army of wigger girls headed this way.
I don't know if that was for a joke, but she did that to her eyebrows.
This is great. Look at that mouth. Doesn't even move it.
This woman's
trying to
teeth look like they're going
to
come out like alien mouth.
You've never seen it.
Like there's other teeth above those.
Look at Ralph. Look at Ralph, son.
All right, you got a... Yeah.
I mean, come on. Come on.
Fucking Ralph. I wish that ended with a guy jump kicking him through the window. Turn these off.
Are you sure you want to turn it off? You can't turn it off. That's the thing about this. You can't turn
I know,
it off.
I want to so bad.
Look how hot he is. Mickey.
It's just sad dudes in their house.
It really is.
Videos.
It's just sad men in houses. Look at that. Cool mask.
What are you? That's a possum. It's a possum mask. Possum.
Oh, random possum.
Why do you, how do you know possums work?
Is my sexuality bothering you?
I'll fuck you.
You fuck that kid?
I don't know what you are.
Guys, what is this?
I think that's Shawn Michaels' daughter.
God damn.
Is that Heartbreak Kid's daughter?
She look like Shawn Michaels.
Go back. You gotta get Shawn Michaels' daughter.
Oh, look at that. She looks like she's from the Soder family with that tone.
I was going to say.
Oh, you know this one. This is TV stuff. I wouldn't expect. Christine's. She doesn't know what's happening. She met.
Yeah, that big headed. That's a big head trouble right there.
I like it, dude. If we fucked, she would die in childbirth for sure.
If you were fraternals?
Yeah, if we fucked. No, if we fucked and had a baby, she would get ripped open like a fucking Christmas present.
That looks like Shawn Michaels.
Yeah,
play
more.
Yeah.
See, it's tough to make fun of because that's clearly a girl that's, you know, mentally handicapped in her room making a fun video.
Yeah.
Well, let's take our first break.
That's the internet.
They're not mentally handicapped, but they're just dumb.
No, well, no, some of them. No,
the lady with clearly like a...
That one was clearly special.
Some of them definitely.
You thought she was just a dumb lady that was working out her neck?
Brain.
Jacked neck?
Yeah. Look at her jacked ass neck.
You have what I believe we're calling a jogged brain.
Yeah. Don't worry.
Brain
you're
got
just,
jogged.
Your intelligence is foggy. You'll be okay.
Let's take our first break. We'll be right back. We're hanging out with Shane Gillis. It's the Lost Tapes. It's...
An
the
acoustic.
Bonfire.
It's an acoustic loft. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio.
Man, whatever song's playing, right?
So rocking hard. Good that we chose it because it's so rocking hard.
I thought we were going to go with acoustics. We're calling this the acoustic thing.
Yeah, it's so acoustically well played.
Man, it was so acoustic.
So man, that's all wind instruments. It's the Lost Tapes acoustic, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson.
That's Shane Gillis.
Yeah. Joining us from the Matt and Shane Secret Podcast.
Yes.
Shane Gillis.
Again.
And again.
In our last break, I took a shower. You guys.
Watched Vines.
Went off on Vines.
Yeah, Vines.
We'll watch them in the studio with everybody.
Vines that keep me from ending it all. That's what it's called. Phenomenal.
It's so fun.
Yeah.
Gil's here. Gil's always part of one of my favorite stories. Did I tell that on the Bonfire? I had to.
What story?
I definitely told him we were watching that thing on Bouncers. I was like, when Gil and Omar were bouncers at Comic Strip.
Yeah.
And the little, like, frat kid came out. And when he realized, one, they couldn't just hit him.
Mm-hmm.
And two, he couldn't beat them. He just thought about it. Because he was going to start some shit. And then he just looked at both of them and thought about it. And then he just goes, you guys are so gay. And they just walked out, man. I laughed for 40 minutes straight. It's funny, I know the thing. I mean, this guy, Gil and Omar would. I mean, this guy was small.
Yeah,
and it was just such a hilarious, like, fucker. He just saw these sizes at the moment. And just goes, he actually wisely did everything he can do, and nothing that it would get him like in more trouble. He was already getting booted, you know.
Yeah.
I mean? So he just left with the last word, and it's so fun. That is the plight of the fucking bouncer, dude.
Yeah.
Is you really can't just hit. You can't just go. You know?
No, you
your
have
instincts.
To, you have to be.
Like, I can be in your face, going like, "I hope your mother sucks my fucking dick later."
It's almost like
you gotta go, sir. Please.
It's almost like violence edging. You know,
yeah.
Like when you're edging, and you're like, "Not yet, not yet." Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, get you right to the brink. Your dad's a piece of shit.
You know what? I'm about to lose it. I'm about to lose it all over you.
It's tantric insults.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to go down it. He's like, and also, bro, I could buy and sell you. And you're like, I'm fucking kill you. I love watching those clips on YouTube of just fucking drunk college kids getting smacked at fucking bars.
Oh, when bouncers just lose it? I know, but bouncers, you really do. You go, that bouncer 100% lost his job, probably had legal charges brought up. Unless you have a club that fucking really supports you. Caroline's, I will say, used to heavily support their fucking security staff because they'd have things where they'd get caught.
Yeah, but I'm talking about
people would try to sue and stuff, and they really backed up their security.
I'm talking about videos on YouTube where it's like a college bar.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just like a gigantic black dude just fucking like open hands a guy across the street.
I was
whoa, that was crazy. I'm sorry.
I was a bouncer at a college bar, and I was obviously – I didn't do shit. I was just – I let every single person in. I didn't even need to see – people would hand me their fucking school IDs, and I'd be like
– checks out.
Try better, but yes. I was like, just give me a card, and I'll let you in. I don't give a fuck.
It's like you're a terrible employee because they're doing that because the place is going to get shut down.
For I didn't give a fuck. They were giving me like 50 bucks.
100% that was Gentle Ben's when I went to University of Arizona. On Thursday night, if you had – any form of ID you could get to, and they're like, thanks. And you're like, well, I'm going to go get fucked up.
Yeah. But the other bouncer was like just learning how to train MMA. He was waiting for it. And then when I quit, he got fired for just choking the fuck out of someone.
Yeah, because
like in the back alley after they kicked him out.
Can't wait for it. That's so great.
He was so excited to try this move out.
What's up, man? You bothering this young lady? He goes, this is my boyfriend. Yeah. We're talking. He goes, I just look like at one point he grabbed your arm. He goes, he was taking me to the dance floor.
All right.
The dance. He goes, I'm just saying, if there's any kind of a problem, I swear to God, I would drop this guy in record time.
He goes, no, it's fine. He goes, I don't need to hear a thing out of you. I'm asking your girlfriend. You want to get handsy with her, get handsy with me.
You lady, you're making it worse, lady. You need to turn on her.
Yeah.
This is a good one. This guy was hooking up with this other dude's sister. So then the younger brother came up to be like, what the fuck are you doing? And the dude slapped him across the face. And I was just standing there, and I was like, all right, you have to leave. Yeah. Like, you guys. But the little brother was closest to me. So I was like, you're out. And he was like, what the fuck, man? And I was like, you got to go, dude. I just saw you get in a fight.
Yeah.
So his sister was getting grinded on. He got punched, and I kicked him out. And then I was like, I'm going to go get the other guy. And he was like, well, I'm going to wait. And I was like, well, now I'm not getting him. Now that guy gets to hang out with your sister.
I love a
pussy. You sure you don't want to leave? And he was like, all right, I'll leave. Then I got the other guy.
You did get the other guy.
It was great, though, walking up to him and being like, you got to go. He's like, yeah, I know.
Oh, really?
He walked out. He like, yeah.
Yeah, because you're always afraid they're going to be like, no, I don't.
Yeah, there's
one rational. He goes, yeah.
Damn.
No, they are. You can get – if you just walk up to them and are like, dude.
Come on.
I just saw you punch a guy.
I believe it's never once happened in a comedy club where someone that was asked to leave can possibly wrap their brain around why they're being thrown.
Never.
I tried to make a joke about it at Caroline's. Didn't really get a big response, actually. But
yeah, I remember.
It is such a funny – like it's always – they always go – I guess we're getting kicked out because you're not allowed to laugh at a comedy club.
Oh, or they use the word enjoy. Oh, I guess you're not allowed to enjoy yourself.
Yeah. Everyone around us was talking. We were laughing. And it's like, no, you're getting kicked out.
We were helping the show. He was talking to us.
It's never you got the – by the way, it's never that you got the wrong people. Yeah. It's always like, no, what I was doing, you're misinterpreting.
Dude, that one summer when
screaming next to the stage, what? That's we can't do that at comedy clubs now.
I'm so sorry. When I worked at Fiddler's Green when I was in high school, I worked at the Kenny Rogers. That was a Kenny Rogers incident. I'm Kenny Rogers.
Hey.
So we went in for the last couple songs, and right before the Gambler, like before he closed it out, we watched this girl shit out of her boyfriend, and concert security did. Nothing.
Yeah.
I mean, I was concert security. I had my shirt off. I was off the clock. But watching that, dude,
not fighting back.
Girl was, and they were both hammered, just Eastern Colorado garbage.
Yeah.
And they were like, and she was just fucking piping him with uppercuts. And he's just like, bruh, 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 just fucking eating it. And you just saw yellow
shirts. He's so bad.
Come on, my mother hits hard.
He's so bad.
Come on. Is that all you got?
Oh.
Yeah. She was doing the Clubber Lang shot that she was doing.
He's getting beat. Nah, he's getting mad.
She had a white mouthpiece with a little bit of blood on it. Yeah, dude, it was fucking crazy. And then they just let her stop. And then they were like, you have to leave.
Yeah.
I think they arrested her.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
That's odd.
She kicked the shit out of it, dude.
He can't hurt me. You hit the hammer head.
Yeah.
He can't hurt me.
But the boyfriend got up and was like, you didn't knock me down, Ray.
Yeah. I didn't hear no bell.
Yeah. You didn't knock me down. You never knocked me down, Ray.
You never knocked me down.
Yeah. It's concert security. Bouncing's just got to be a consistent thing where you're like, every Thursday night by around 1 o'clock, you know you're going to have a problem.
Yeah.
Because, call time was, I think when I went to school at Arizona, it moved from, last call went from 1 a.m. to 2 a.m., which was an insane night. Bouncers must have been suiting up like it was fucking D-Day.
Oh, that's like that.
Dropped it back an hour, and it was on a Thursday, which was the party night at the University of Arizona. I can't imagine being a bouncer and they're like, woo!
Yeah.
This is your destiny! This is why we walk these hollow halls!
God.
Of O'Malley's. What was the other?
Being a bouncer just stinks.
Dude, I watched
girls yelling in your face has to be, though, like, you're a fucking idiot. You know, and they're like, I can't let you in. And they're like, fuck you. Suck. Yeah. You know,
dude, you're
security,
fat.
Security.
Yeah, you're fat.
I went to a.
You're the fat one. That's why I couldn't let you in.
Whatever. Hammer handles.
Dude, we were at a PNC Arena once for Slayer Marilyn Manson. And the fucking, I mean, these animals, the lawn.
Yeah.
You know, there's like a gate in front of the lawn. They all tried. They tried aggressively and succeeded in tugging back and forth on so much they pulled it out of the concrete. And security was just over there. People were just handing them the pieces of concrete. And then the front of the lawn was just a wall of people waiting to fucking fall to their 15-foot death.
They can't do this!
It was insane.
What the fuck? What the fuck? That's like King Rat.
Yeah, dude.
They just crawl up over each other like.
Dude, people can't be the barrier of something where there's nothing in front of them.
No, they can't. You can't just have other people.
The bottom of a hill barrier of people having fucking mosh pits going is just people.
Dude,
just the people who were in the front of that.
It's just so funny, though, like how animalistic it gets with people breaking out like that. Same job when I worked concert security. We did the Warp Tour. With Green Day and Jurassic
Kenny
Five.
Rogers, where shit got turned up.
Dude, no. Warp Tour, we were in the parking thing, and they were trying to
get out.
And
my mom said that I have to be home in my school day.
Better let me
out or I'm going to yell.
That was Papa Roach when the girl got dropped, where he's like, cut my life in. And then the girl dropped. He goes, stop, hold on. And they stopped the show. They stopped Last Resort. To be like, make sure she's all right.
That's
like,
hilarious.
Suffocation. And you saw this girl just boom, right down. And we were there. We were in the back. We're like, oh, fuck. He's like, goes, stop.
Everyone will die. Ho, ho, ho. Whoa, hey. Band-aid check over there, huh?
What happened?
I saw some sharp elbows flying over there.
You guys are being mean. But, dude, we're all 16, and we were all working in, like, the parking area. And my friend Chad was in front of this gate, you know? And one guy was like, hey, man, I'm, like, already at the gate. Chad was 16, so, like, the guy kind of yelled him into being like, let me out this gate real quick with my car. Because he was, like, right to the highway. It was just cut. And Chad was like, all right. Just let one. Then it was like, yeah. Just like 50 cars. And our boss is like, where are all these people coming from? And I'm standing there like, why did you do that? He had to pull his car in front. Dude, it was fucking crazy. Everyone's like, let me the fuck out of here. And you're just 16. You're like, I can't.
Yeah. Have you ever gotten to go with a bouncer?
No. Because the only time I ever got to go with a bouncer was after I got robbed. I confronted the guy that set us up. At a bar in Tucson, and he was like, you want to go outside? And I was like, I would love to go outside. I think I've told the story on the bonfire before. And we were talking shit to each other walking in front of the bar, and right when we got outside, he was like, this guy's got a knife, to the bouncer, and the bouncer fucking gave me the forearm shiv under the chin and like put me against the wall. And I was like, I don't have a knife. I was like,
oh, dude, that's not a cool fucking lie.
The way you talk with someone's forearm jammed in, you go, oh,
come on, dude. Yeah, that's true.
This guy hit me up.
And he was just, this guy was such a piece of shit. He just did it, you know, because then they swarmed me.
It's a good move.
He got out of it.
He dipped?
I was going to fuck his shit up.
By the way. In the movie, though, that guy's the smoothest motherfucker in the world.
Not my
movie. I'm going to whoop your fucking ass. He goes, you don't even see it coming. I know you think you're bigger than me, but I will fucking end your shit nice and early. This guy's got a knife.
Yes, exactly. He was overweight. He was a big fella, so I was just calling him Fatso on the walk. I was like, I'm going to punch your fat ass. And then he just so cool and casually, right? He goes, he has a knife to the bouncer. And the
bouncer, hilarious.
Fucking the one next to me, it was just one arm under my chin. We're like, yeah.
I was in an argument with a guy yesterday who I called fat several times over and over again.
Felt good.
I'll tell you, man, dork. Dork is the one that feels. When I got into it with that guy at the electric car charge station, when I called him a dork, I could see his fucking him move on.
I hate nerds.
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 Nerds. Nerds. Who would ever thought that they're actually the good guys in the movie.
The nerds are. There's a rapist. Your leader's a rapist.
Yeah. By the way, all you guys are doing is illegal shit. You're monitoring the sorority. These are bad people.
Didn't they do a panty raid?
Yeah.
They did a panty raid. They also set up cameras to spy on them with voyeur cameras, which you would do major time for that. Yeah. I mean, major time.
Lambda's looking at least a cold 25. They're looking at a cold 25.
And by the way, you think Omega Moo's not going down as accomplice? They were standing right
behind
Omega
Moo knew what was happening.
As the song tells you, they're Lambda.
Then they sold Omega pies. Moo. With their pictures from
the naked
they
girls.
Did revenge porn. It should be called revenge porn. Is what that movie
revenge of the porn nerds.
Yeah,
porn of the nerds.
Revenge porn of the nerds is what the nerds did.
He raped the captain of the football team's girlfriend.
Yeah, Darcy. Sick. Shout out Darcy.
Sick move.
He raped her and
he wore a Darth Vader mask.
And then they did a panty raid. And what you call it? It's been said 1,000 times why Cobra Kai exists. Dana LaRusso's kind of sticking his fucking little jerk-off nose in where it didn't belong.
Yeah. The whole piece time. Of fucking New
guys
Jersey.
Guys, just fuck. Yeah.
Yeah, night New Jersey Paisan just shows up in L.A. causing problems for the Cobra.
Maybe you got to fuck him up at the beach.
The shit was over, and he poured water on the guy.
Yeah, man. He was rolling a joint. Gary Goldman has a great bit about that when he talks about how hard it is to roll a joint.
Yeah,
and he's like, Daniel LaRusso, what are you doing? You're inviting the ass meeting. But he's right. It's like, dude, yeah. This is the same thing with the nerds.
Yeah,
Revenge of the Nerds. We're so woke, we're against Revenge of the Nerds.
I was against them before it was a problem.
Because they're nerds.
I hate the nerds.
You look like Ogre's your dad.
I fucking... Yeah, he kind of was. He kind of was, dude.
If Ogre was like... If you were cast...
I wish
Revenge
my dad was Booger, dude.
Oh, Booger's... Booger Gary, Gary's got a lot of Booger vibes.
Your dad? Maybe a Booger?
Yeah, but more of a... The way that he just dressed and you know...
My dad was just one of the guys...
Wasn't he Anthony?
He was like second string fullback. Maybe.
Your dad said he's second tier Lambda.
Yeah. He was there for the fights.
Yeah.
He threw down. Maybe infantry front line of the throwdown.
Yeah,
but just you know,
did they ever fight?
He wasn't the guy crushing all the puss and all. Yeah.
Did the good guys, the jocks, ever beat the shit out of the dorks?
No, they lose their
They got crushed.
Well, what happens is their house. Burns down.
Make no mistake, they're not good guys.
Yeah. Dude, the jocks?
The jocks, the alphas.
They're not good guys.
I kind of support that.
I don't know if you come back with the kind of not good guys they were with raping their girlfriends and filming them all naked against their will.
Destroying their privacy.
It just seems bizarre.
Damn.
Now, here's the thing. Should they ban the whole movie? Nope. Because there's a lot of funny in that movie.
It's a great movie.
But it is definitely not a good message.
You know, when you watch it later in life, you're like, whoo, that didn't play out well.
Different.
That was a five-year plan. You guys had a five-year plan on that theme.
We were watching Mighty Ducks last night.
Mighty Ducks, not a good movie.
Bro, I was cheering for the Hawks.
Like, not a good, like...
Mighty Ducks, no. Gordon Bombay is a piece of shit.
Yeah.
He's a high-power lawyer that gets fucking a DUI, has to teach these kids...
And he's a moron. And then he quits his fucking job for a little league
crazy.
Hockey team.
He starts accosting people by quacking at him.
When he loses it?
Yeah.
And he fucks his
he
star players.
Takes Adam Banks from the Hawks. Yeah. There's a scene where
he fucks the star player's mom?
Yeah.
Fucks the star player's mom. He's Gordon Bombay.
He like moves in with the star player.
But yeah,
he's like, hey man, you got a fucking couch I can crash
moves
on?
In with him, and then
maybe
goes,
a mom
and then the movie goes and tries out for the NHL in his 30s.
Very inappropriate.
You know how irresponsible and reckless that is? Just to fucking leave your job as a lawyer to go try out for the NHL?
The Hawks head coach is the man.
Yeah. He's got his collar pop. But here's the point I was trying to make. Was their star, Adam Banks, is originally on the Hawks. But they find out he's in the Mighty Ducks district. So they make him switch teams. And in the movie, you're always like, well, that's great. They got a player. When you watch it as a kid, you're like, good. I like the Ducks. Good for them. But then there's a speech where his dad's like, you can't. His friends are on that team. And you're like, that's a fucking great point.
Yeah.
This kid's friends are on the Hawks, and you're forcing him to play with a ragtag bunch of weirdos?
Fuck that guy.
Fuck the Ducks.
Yeah.
Team Hawks. Shane wants a Hawks
I need
jacket.
A Hawks jersey or jacket.
Shane wants the Hawks. He goes, immediately goes, now this team's my speed.
Dude, how about that fist bump the coach gives him in the penalty box? So he sends his goons out to fucking
to hurt
the
a child.
Team.
This is just all in a kid's movie.
He's like, why don't you go fuck this kid up? kid goes out, McGill goes out and fucks up the Hawks or the Mighty Ducks' best player, and his teammate's like, "What are you doing?" He's like, "I'm doing my job." It's like, hell yeah, dude. That kid's a warrior.
Enforcer.
But it was like, you know what was funny? Watching Shane watch a bully in a movie like that, it's like
it.
It's like watching a dog watch a dog on TV. Yeah, and Shane's like, huh, huh. Yeah. That guy's bullying that kid.
Shane calls Billy Madison O'Doyle Rules.
Yeah, yeah.
You guys want to watch O'Doyle Rules?
You guys want to watch the but it's a drama to him because they die. He goes, but it's really sad.
It's one of the saddest. It's one of the saddest middles.
It follows the killer shortly after their demise.
Honestly, I cheer for the O'Doyle. You got to cheer for the O'Doyles in that.
Dude.
A fucking arrogant billionaire comes back to high school. Every grade he's in, and O'Doyle's there to try to stop him. Every grade, there's a great O'Doyle.
The hero we, it's not the hero we want. It's the hero we deserve. Dude, that's so funny. You think of all the people in all these movies who actually have a legitimate case against the main character.
Dude,
the O'Doyles is such a good case.
O'Doyles is a good
against
case.
Billy Madison?
Yeah, he's a billionaire.
Fantastic.
They're like, fuck this guy. We're hardworking, poor, big idiots.
Yeah.
We didn't get a second chance. We got run off a cliff.
Lost Boys, man. Just wanted to make a family.
They really did. They really did. What's wrong with that?
Just wanted a fucking vampire family.
Yeah. And also...
And instead, what do? They sneak in while they're sleeping like bitches.
Bitches!
And put a stake through fucking Bill S. Preston Esquire's heart.
I can't believe I'm going to say this, but I feel bad for the T-1000. It's only fucking job.
It's programmed.
It's programmed. It can't help how it's programmed. Yeah. It's sent back in time. It's liquid metal. It can bend to whatever it sees and copies. Also a floor, which they never explain. I rewatched T2.
It can become floor?
He was the floor. He was the linoleum floor all of a sudden. And then he's the person, you know, when he pokes the cop drinking the coffee. Why is he a floor? Floor's not metal.
By the way, he was also part of floor.
Yeah. He was like the floor.
Yeah.
And then
was
he
stupid.
Like, it was stupid. But it doesn't make sense with the logic of... I get off topic.
Here's one.
T-1000... was just trying to help his other robot friends.
He's doing what he's bred for.
He's basically Wally. He's Wally.
He's Wally.
T-1000 is Wally. He's just a cute robot trying to help other robots.
I thought that was Chappie.
You're Chappie.
You're the one who's Chappie.
Dude, get Chappie with me, bro.
You're Chappie Brew. Are you Chappie Brew?
Chappie Brew?
Brew. There's a movie called like The Descent. You ever see that?
Yeah,
it's like
the creatures in a cave.
Yeah, these nice creatures. Just because they're ugly, it's like, oh, good. I hope the hot people kill them.
they just stay in their cave.
They don't even come out.
We were saying this about 12 Strong. Is the it's all the Navy SEALs in the movie are like hot dudes.
Yeah.
So if there's just like a gay Taliban leader who's like, here's what we want. Take off your shirt and lay with me for a little bit.
We're talking about
give me the information or don't. Just do it with your pants on.
Kiss me. Don't do it.
That's why they
you take off your pants.
Pantalones.
That's why they did 9/11. They're like, we knew America have the hottest soldiers. We want our country filled with hunks. So we terrorize the
people of the Taliban. We shall load up Afghanistan with hot boys.
We promise.
Hot boys.
We promise nothing but hunks.
Men. From Middle America.
Oh.
Hot body
the
boys.
The hottest boys are on their way.
You realize the Taliban's just secretly super gay? And then it's like, and then ISIS is like, honey, please.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you seen the boys coming up in the horses?
Oh my God. They are
I can't tell where the horse muscles end and the man muscles begin.
They're dream cocks.
Allah has blessed us with the hottest hunks. The Prophet Muhammad has foreseen the hot hunks. The hot hunks are here. You're gonna sheep. The one of them I think is Thor.
If the prophecy is correct, cute boys be parachuting in right in this longitude. Just super gay ISIS.
Also, the Taliban after 9/11 and Osama bin Laden being like, all right, I'm going into hiding. The rest of the guys got to be like, oh, you're gonna attack the United States and then hide?
Oh, okay.
We'll just stay here.
Are you giving Dan notes?
Christine just handed me an article that's just so fucking sad. It says Afghan soldiers are using boys as sex slaves and the U.S. is looking the other way. Cool. Well, that really just ruined
the joke. You don't get between a Taliban and his boys.
Yeah. No, it's the Afghan soldiers that are using it. Our side.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. You really need to reconsider the hiring of General Joseph Paterno.
He goes, I got nothing left. Let me get over there.
Come to Penn State. U.S. soldiers.
Come to Penn State.
No, no. The Afghan soldiers are using the kids. And the Afghan U.S. police. Soldiers are like, all right, well, that's their culture.
Oh, they're using kids for...
What's that?
No, they're fucking kids.
They're fucking them.
Yeah, it says... This is how the article starts. It says, last summer, an Afghan police commander invited me to his post for tea and to view his, quote, beautiful boy sex slave. You're telling me there's no love.
Beautiful.
I mean, blush.
Yeah. Hearts, emoji eye. Emoji, heart eyes.
Beautiful?
Did
you hear him say I was beautiful?
Yeah. He won't let me see the sun, but that makes it worth it.
I don't go outside, but it's often raining compliments here in my cage.
On its open roof, a slight teenager sat next to his hulking... Did you hand me fucking a Daniel Steele novel?
You trying to get him hard?
It is the Washington Post. His chest had a spritz of sweat.
Yeah.
Glistening down to his navel.
Yeah. His heaving.
Throbbing manhood.
The Afghan police commander could feel it. Yeah. In his work slacks. The building anticipation.
Sweat beginning to bead up on the forehead as he makes his way into his manhood.
He could feel his chest. He could feel his chest beat through his bulletproof
vest. At the exact moment that two became one.
Dude, it really is like that. It really is. This is how it's written. On its open roof, a slight teenager sat next to his hulking captor. Stealing sad
glances. Hello.
Hey. Stealing sad glances.
I don't know. Did you guys paint a picture? He said they're both sitting in lawn chairs.
Yeah.
He goes, hello.
Hi. Hey. I'm Kyle.
Yeah. Hey, I'm your new neighbor.
Welcome to the neighborhood. Yeah. This is my boy.
I'm a captor.
Yeah.
This is my beautiful, beautiful sex slave boy, eh?
Pretty nice for a guy like me.
Yeah, pretty impressive, yes? I myself am tops a four.
I'm funny. That's the thing. I know I don't look like I would have such a beautiful boy, but I am very funny.
I have connections to the people that put you in the torture sex. On its open roof, a slight teenager sat next to his hulking captor. Stealing sad glances at me as he quietly filled our tea glasses. How weird is it to be hanging out with a dude when you know for sure his boy sex slave is filling up your tea, and you go, that's enough. I'm good. I'm okay. You know, like that. I'm awkward when they fill my water at restaurants.
Would you rather he suck your penis?
Yeah, he goes, want to lick his butthole? Yeah, no, I don't. No.
It's delicious.
Oh, a shock of auburn curls jutted out of his embroidered pillow box hat, and his milky
eyes.
Is this
written from a positive
angle? We're lined with coal. The commander flaunted him the way a ringmaster exhibits an exotic animal. See my beautiful baja, he said, blithe and casual, a gun dangling at his side. The commander, an ally of the United States in the war against the Taliban, is not an anomaly. Hundreds of such outposts of the Afghan local police.
Wait, just pause for 1 second. I have to ask you a question.
Sure.
I'm getting lost here.
Yeah.
Is this written? Wait a second. Is this news?
Yeah, this is going to be one of those ones where setting the scene.
Are you reading quotes, or did the writer describe? Is it the writer just describing this third person to you?
Just writer
what
describing
they saw.
Third person.
So they're actually doing it. And he goes, a slight auburn curl of hair.
That's why I said it was written like an
drift. No, I know, but I thought like I actually thought for a minute you were reading like fiction or something.
This is a real thing.
This is real.
What psycho wrote this?
Yeah, really.
A frontline force armed and funded with U.S. taxpayer dollars and other pro-government militias are believed to have enslaved young boys for dancing and sexual companionship.
Up comes his slave.
I don't
sticky from semen.
Yeah, many of them kidnapped, but that's. Enslave young boys for dancing? That's
weird. Come on.
You want to see him dance?
We should all be so lucky.
Just dance real quick. He's like,
oh no, he's not my fuck one.
Yeah. No, this dance one is sleeping.
Oh, he's not fuck one. He's dance one.
Yeah. Great moves on this kid, though.
I couldn't hurt that tussy with my penis. Look at it move.
His moves like Jagger. That's what I renamed him.
Would be a crime.
Yeah, dude, it's fucked up. That's really fucked up.
Anyway. His freedom. Man juices cascaded off his back. I was appalled.
So it's basically this article saying that the U.S. knows about it. It's not doing anything about it.
I watched as he gently and tenderly entered his slave.
Yeah.
I couldn't believe myself. I had to keep writing. I didn't think even once to intervene or...
Yeah, this guy's really Sex in the City, yeah. Fucking horrible thing. He goes, you know, they say boys aren't only good for a couple of things, but apparently being a sex slave is another one. It's like, thanks, Samantha. Or which one wrote the articles? Carrie, right?
Carrie.
Thanks. I'm going outside knowledge here. Love the show.
How many episodes have you watched?
Never seen an episode.
Never watched one full episode of Sex in the City.
I've only picked up all those references from other people referencing it.
I've definitely seen an episode.
Yeah, I didn't have the HBO until about 5 years ago.
What's the face you made, Christine?
You just looked at so many women.
Yeah.
Hey, good job.
Do you control women. The shows, Christine?
No, but I
mean, exactly.
What?
Well, what I was. Does Christine she was watch saying it? You lived with enough women that you would have seen it, and I was like, do you think Jay's letting some broad control the fucking what show they're watching?
No, but there's definitely but there definitely is like a walk into the room and it's on and it's like, I'm not going to fucking just go dominate if they're watching something and I'll just like, you sit and end up like watching it. But I've never seen anything from it that ever made me go, I wonder where this storyline's going.
Yeah.
Like I'd never, you know, it's not a show I ever got into. I got into Sopranos like late and didn't go backwards, by the way. When I came in, Big Pussy already dead.
So you've never seen season one?
No.
Season one is unbelievable.
Yeah? No, I never watched it. But was it, how many seasons? Nine, did it go? I watched like 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Do you want to start a rewatch?
I think it was like 3, 5.
You better get that rewatch. They're getting a movie going right now.
I know. They're doing a prequel.
Yeah.
Do you want to sync up? This comes out on Thursday. Sync up with Campers and start doing a Sopranos rewatch?
It's a real commitment.
You know what we could do is we could do some special downloadable companion pieces.
Hey,
on
Colorado.
The
get your foot up on my fucking awesome coffee table.
Sorry.
Damn.
I'm so used to having a shitty coffee table.
Cowboy stance.
Yeah.
Fuck the world.
I'm just used to a shitty coffee table.
No, I know.
Sorry.
I didn't think you were doing it to be nasty.
I was doing it to Alpha.
I thought you were doing it to be Alpha Dog. Yeah.
I was Alpha.
And fuck this thing.
I was like.
Get it back up there. Get it back up there.
You guys just hear dripping. It's me pissing on it.
that's not my feet.
You go, dude, it's all over your phone and your recorder.
He goes, that's not my feet at all, man.
What? That's not my feet. That's not coming out. I'm not touching it.
I'm not touching it at all.
I'm not touching you.
I can't put things on it?
I'm not touching it.
I can't put piss on this table.
Let's take our last break, and then we'll be back with the last segment on the acoustic...
Lost tapes.
Yes.
I'm sure Lou's putting a sweet special effect to this.
Right now.
Lou, if you listened to this, if you didn't listen to this.
Lou, if you're hearing this, it's too late. We're already dead.
We've been lost in space for over 3 years. I thought Shane was planning against me, but it was Jay the entire time. I shot his
We
house
figured
pot.
Out a way to grow fruit.
Yeah. We've learned vegetables are growing aboard. We're going near the sun. Oh, how it makes Shane happy. Oh, the warmth. How it makes him happy. Tell a story.
It's the bonfire, everybody.
I love you. Goodbye. We'll be right back. Right? That's how you say that.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
It is. The bonfire.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I am Dan Soder.
I am Big J. Oakerson.
And that is Shane Gillis. We sound like we're on a lot of hallucinogenics right now. I am this.
I am, right? Like, I am.
But we are that. It's Thursday.
Everyone's everything. Let's do our plugs. We haven't done plugs today.
DanSoder.com. I will be in Rochester, New York at Comedy at the Carlson. The dates. TBD. No, they're up on my website. I just can't think of it right now. I believe it is June 6th through the 8th. And then the 13th through the 15th, I'll be at Zany's in Chicago. DanSoder.com for tickets. cc.com/bonfire.
Hell yeah.
For our website. Shane, where are you at?
I'm with Jay.
Ooh.
At the Tampa Improv. When the 6th, 7th, and 8th?
6th, 7th, and 8th.
Oh, 6th, all right. 7th, and 8th.
14th and 15th, I'm at Bananas.
Yes, Hasbrook Heights. Heights.
Yes.
Jersey.
The, is that good? Is that, you
know? Yeah, fuck it. Matt and Shane Secret Podcast. Suck our dicks.
Suck our dicks.
Suck our fucking dicks, Matt.
BigJComedy.com. After that Tampa gig, the weekend after, I believe, I am in Kansas City at the Improv out there. First time going out there.
Hey!
I always did
Sanford Sons.
You know, I always did
yeah, you got Starbucks there. Kind of
Dong's there.
Bim's there. Jay's killing.
Bim's, Jay's, Dong's,
Bim,
Jay,
Boop,
Hell.
Bibi, Bop, Bibi, da, da.
One time, gangster.
I'm an angel. I'm an angel up in heaven.
Hey, it's the glaze from heaven.
Hey,
it's pretty great.
It's Angel Glaze.
I just did a sting operation on Jesus because I'm the king of sting, baby.
Found out. Turns out he's been smuggling wine. Through Warner.
It looks like he's just taking Warner.
Man, that is weird that we've had someone that we've, like, watched their web. He was the owner of Sanford and Sons in Connecticut, in Kansas City, and he had this web series called A Man and His Dog, and we watched all the episodes on this show, and he died. Like,
some say from heartbreak of what we yep, said.
He said Jay crushed him. That he thought Jay was his last chance at a regular life. Jay was his last chance.
I thought we were really going to give it a try yeah, this time.
Jay was really his last shot at having everything he ever wanted. And he blew it.
What'd this guy do with the dog?
He looked like he would sort of like awkwardly...
He would just make the dog sit there as he told a story about banging sluts.
We're making out. I have a blouse off. We're skirt up. I got my wiener out.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, basically.
That's a pretty sick show.
You would love him. Yeah,
yeah, this guy sounds awesome.
No, he's Shane Gillis certified.
He's telling slut stories to dogs?
Yeah, two dogs and us.
I do that. Get a little fucked up. Go
do you
home,
think they pulled?
Tell Riggins
do you
about
think
some
that they pulled?
No way
did,
they pulled.
Did he have
these.
Children?
Huh?
Did he have children?
No way did he have children. Not a chance. I would never
Damn,
believe.
Damn, what'd he die from?
Just getting too much pussy.
Plus,
the dogs yeah. finally had enough of the story.
Yeah, they Game of Thrones him.
They got him.
What was that guy's name? The one with the dogs?
Yeah.
He's torturing. People listening
I forget.
Are probably so upset.
I forget his name.
Well, he's Mars. He's
Israel Cocksucker.
He's Mick Mars in the Dirt. That's man, the name of the basin, man. Right?
Yeah.
For Motley Crue? I don't want to say
I think Mars is right.
Mick That's, Mars is his name.
Yes. Sometimes I say stuff.
The old guy from.
I don't know if that's true.
Do I got to put
Oh,
it,
man. Right? Man punches kangaroo in the face. He's right there. That's,
that's pretty bad.
It's one of the greatest videos ever.
Yeah, because the kangaroo's about to fuck his dog up, right?
Kangaroo gets popped in the face and is like, what? What? Oh, we're squaring up? Oh, you got me. You got one. You better run, dude.
Better get the fuck out of here. Is it pulled? Oh,
wow.
There it is.
That's the dog he's telling Sniz stories to?
Yeah. Look at us. Our bond, the bonfire.
Just a dachshund?
Oh, the bonfire right in there. Maria. These are great, dude. It's been a while since we brought you a man and his dog.
So I go out and get the food, and I think I smell bacon burning, right? And I went, I didn't make any bacon. Oh, my God. It wasn't bacon. The rubber head had come off the vibrator, and the thing was vibrating, and it was almost on fire. It was like a hot poker coal. She passed out. It was laying on her pussy, and her pussy was being cooked. Wow. So I did all I could. I had to take her to the hospital. I don't know if they sewed her pussy shut or not. I never saw her again. But I'll tell you what, I don't eat bacon anymore.
But that's the idea.
Yeah. You got a taste. You got a little fucking key bump.
So Luke added that out. And his girl dog and... Talks yeah. prison sex.
We just talked about every story's about how much pussy he got.
Yeah, dog's face paws on his grave.
It really is every about how badass. It's always it's the thing that we always make fun of on this show where it's like there's no way you're the winner in every way
yeah.
of this story.
He has like a you know the girl's begging to suck my dick. What am I going to do? Run away? You know I let her suck my dick.
You know what I mean, like, Junior? You know what I mean, 90-year-old dachshund? I love
yeah, that milky-eyed dog's just yeah. sitting there like. Help me.
We have it paused on this dog's face. It's like, even the dog's like, can you fucking believe this? Can you fucking believe this guy is telling this story?
I fucking depend on this idiot in for food.
He's wearing a Kansas City Chiefs windbreaker.
He goes, you know what that's like?
Short sleeve windbreaker.
And by the way, he's not a coach of any sorts.
Short sleeve pullover Chiefs windbreaker.
Allegedly. We don't know that.
You're right.
I don't know what he
That's coached. Fucking sick.
That would be crazy. If
short sleeve windbreaker? Short sleeve pullover Chiefs windbreaker?
Dude, oh, you're dressed like Andy Reid?
I need one of those. Yeah, I would, dude. I would look.
You're dressed like Andy Reid?
Oh, shit. Didn't his kid die?
Everyone's after me because I have like the best picks in football.
Yeah.
Talk about his best picks he'd make.
Oh, he has good picks.
Well, he did.
He said he did. Then he would go sexually harass everybody at the radio with you.
Dude, he would do radio with you. Like, he would do radio with
you. No, he would do radio instead of you most of the time.
He would just take it away. He'd be like, you know, I really bring it. And, so
this new intern here, I mean, god damn, you know, what a rack on this one. Are you going to be doing? And you're like, okay, dude, you really can't do that. The new girl goes, watch. And when he leaves, he's like, you see how much he loved it, and I'll text her later, and I'll get her number from so and so. And I goes, well, she'll be sucking my cock by the.
One of the worst shows. Damn. One of the worst shows I've ever had in my life. Right before the show, he goes, "It's Saturday," and he's like, "All right, I gotta get out of here. Got a real slut lined up."
Yeah,
and then
yeah,
there was no one there to police the room.
By the way,
and
this
people,
is something everyone
people just started yelling out, and I was just putting out fires. Oh. Dude, that was the worst show.
But dude, this is something that's something that everybody in this room would say to each other. Because it's the funniest thing
what are
to
these?
Say.
Chocolate?
Yeah.
These good?
Yeah, they're great.
It's taking chances on candy. That's the sweet tooth Danny Sodies.
Everybody would say that to everybody in this room.
Yeah.
I got a slut waiting for me. Because you're saying it as a joke, ultimately.
Yeah.
That's before you go on a date and bring flour. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, you just make that joke.
Yeah.
But, like, he's not friends with us on that level. That's what I always thought was weird about. To say stuff like that, you're like, you're kind of just like, you know. The guy that's contracting me out this weekend. Like,
I took him as a guy that straight up had a slut lined up.
That he means. Yeah. Oh yeah, no, and he wants to tell you. No, it is. I'm saying.
Yeah.
It's not for like a joke. He's telling.
No, he's not.
He's
you're right. He's not joking at all. He
doesn't know us well enough to make.
He's like, hey, whatever, kid. Good luck handling these drunk maniacs that are at a mall next
I've
to the
got
David
a
Busters.
Slut waiting to suck my dick.
I got a for sure thing lined up. I got a hot one ready to go.
Black Barbie. Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
He had a girl. It's called Black Barbie. It's a girl, by the way. I know. A few people like this. I know a couple of white dudes who hook up with like a hot black chick or a little out of their league black chick because they just keep them like supplied in coke constantly.
Go.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Well,
the two people I know have that, like Craig and somebody else, where it's like a weird, like it is like a strippery, like you know, chick. You're like, oh. You keep them like supplied in coke, and they think you're the shit.
Dude, that sucks that he's that option where she's like with people she wants to hang out with, and she's like, there's this guy we can hang out with if you guys really want blow. He's like, I'm going to have to suck his dick. Like, what do you think? What do you think, Andrea? And she goes, here's the thing. He calls me Black Barbie. So we're going to go in there. He's got good yak, though.
Guy does have good yak.
Guy's got some fucking superior.
I mean... Primo. To have to sit here and listen to this bullshit? Yeah. I gotta be in the stratosphere.
Yeah. I'm gonna be toots magoots. I'll be fucking good.
He goes, I mean, eyes bolted.
Yeah, I'm gonna look like a Ren and Stimpy cartoon.
Imagine me.
I'm gonna be fucking vain.
Like fucking Japanime eyes.
Yeah.
Imagine being yacked up and listening to some dude in a windbreaker telling you stories with those two dogs just barking the whole fucking
whole time
and being like, Junior. Stop.
Come here.
Anyway, I was with this slut.
Yeah, slut's just giving.
Oh, shit, that's you. Different story.
Different slut. A younger slut. Younger,
this
meaner.
Dog I stole from a guy I hurt.
This dog and I found in a park. These fucking idiots just left him.
Can you believe someone would do that to a dog?
I mean, draw a line somewhere.
Draw
dogs.
Dude, he gives you a book called The King of Sting when you work the club.
And he's the king.
Yeah.
Dude, he wrote... a thing in mind disparaging another comic. It's so weird.
What'd he say?
I won't say because it's ridiculous. It's
just
like,
don't say the comic. Just say what he said.
It's weird. He goes. You're one of my favorites. Way better than.
No, you gotta say who. You gotta tell us after who it was.
Oh yeah, for sure.
So
someone who's fucking for instance, someone who's amazing. It's just like it makes sense. Like I'm more saying it. But I wanted to go back to that person and have them be like, "That sucks." You said that. I go. I think it was like a joke, but it's just like a weird. Like, why would you write that in my book?
Why would you make
context?
Why would you make an undefined joke permanent by signing your book? Not permanent. I'm not going to keep the book.
You didn't read the book.
I read the whole thing. I read it cover to cover.
You read The King of Sting.
I read the cover to cover.
Was
dude.
He lying or was he the king?
This is the
buddy,
king.
I didn't have to read it because I did that club so many times. I got the book on tape from the dude telling it to my face.
He kept telling
I'll
me
tell you every goddamn story of the things this guy did. They go to the dry cleaners and steal police suits and then or police uniforms, and they go and rob drug dealers, and then like some fucking movie plot hackers thing, the government. This is where it takes me. I think he just got caught doing stuff like that.
Yeah, he did.
Like robbing drug dealers. No, he absolutely got caught on. He goes, the government turned on him because they hired him because he was so good at stings. They hired him to do stings for them. And then they caught him. And when all this went down, he got 11 years in prison.
Did he do 11?
Yeah.
He did 11 years.
I mean, he's an older guy. You know, that was a wig he's wearing.
Yo, he showed that picture of him in prison, and he was kind of swole. He would have fucking wrecked this room.
He tells you that, too. He tells you how fucking jacked he used to be.
He would have came in this room, not with Gil.
He
Gil
looks like the guy.
But us three, I mean, maybe Christine's got a shot. She's Armenian. She's scrappy.
Now, you know, I don't like what you just said. Don't lump me into your fucking puss circle. I'd fuck that dude up. I'd fuck young Craig Laser up.
You couldn't even get past Collinsworth.
Yeah, Chris Collinsworth.
talking about
Chris on, Collinsworth. Dude, we're calling him the king of sting with snapping that jab at you.
Ooh.
When Chris Collinsworth is...
I'll go, all right, guys, he's fast.
He is quick.
Right, I'm still here.
I'm telling you, there's...
Al Michaels surprise. Calling it on the side. Right. Chris Collinsworth dropping back, about to whoop Jay's dumbass.
Okay, all right, surprising quickness.
Oh.
Surprising quickness.
So that's
cool. Still got a little strength. Still got a little strength, too. Okay. All right, we're in a fight, though. We're in a fight. I get it. I know it's going to take some shots.
Ow. Stop.
No, hey, I didn't know it was going to be a flawless victory, right? We're cool. We're still in here.
I'm telling you, the fight is him splashing his whiskey in your face. Slapping you across the face, and then security steps in and carries you outside.
Yeah.
And he says, get this trash out of my face.
Is this Collinsworth v. Oakerson?
Yeah, Collinsworth's walking in a hallway.
What are you doing walking up to me in Shula's Steakhouse?
You know this is where I come to relax.
Where the fuck he splashes the most expensive whiskey your trashy ass has ever tasted.
Can a man just enjoy his meal at John Elway's Steak and Shit?
He goes, Oakerson. I knew you'd ruin my meal at Shanahan's, Denver's premier steakhouse.
Doesn't
I'm
know
here
his
for
name.
The Raiders Broncos Monday Night
listen,
Football game.
Listen, Collinsworth doesn't know Jay's name. He splashes the whiskey, slaps him. They carry him out, and he's like, get this trash out of here. Forgets 5 minutes later.
Done.
Totally.
Moved on.
Jay's out in the parking lot.
He's trying to get me riled up before I go to Legion of Skanks.
Yes. He's giving you a speech.
You got to get fired up. You got to get ready.
That's your time to kill speech.
Get ready.
He's giving you a time to kill.
Yeah, picture. She's white.
Not picture, she's Jay.
Not picture, she's Jay. I don't like that at all. I don't like that one bit. Oh, man.
Wait, who did he say? We said Oakerson. King of Sting could fuck your shit up.
Not a chance.
11 one, years, dead.
If he does now, I bet hand-to-hand, he's zombie glaze versus you.
Zombie glaze versus me? Dude, it's a
tough
quick
fight.
One. Nah, I put a foot right through his chest. Dude, his bones are soft now.
But then he'll just keep coming.
No,
oh.
Dude. He's a zombie. He's still actively deteriorating.
Oh, I start eating you. You go, dogs are there.
Dan, what you're saying is ridiculous. He's a zombie. He's deteriorating.
You're saying
he will
beat
be like
up
buddy.
Zombies. You can beat up zombies. You versus zombies. You beat up zombies.
Listen, I know we're fucking dicking around right here. I know we're horsing around.
We're having fun.
It's my problem almost with The Walking Dead. They almost make the zombie problem like it's too big of a deal. It seems like you could kill 500 yourself on your way to the deli.
Mm-hmm. But then it attracts more.
Huh?
It attracts more zombies.
Keep bringing them, dude. You keep serving them.
You're
going to
gas, dude.
You're going to gas out.
You from stabbing mindless walking humps in the head. Yo. I can't believe they make it a problem on the show.
It's the problem. Because you had gas.
Try to hit the bag 500 times. Try to hit the heavy bag.
Show me. Listen.
You're gassed.
You throw me zombies that sprint, we got an issue. I'm going to get piled on.
I'll go
but
as
I'm
far.
Telling you can kill five. Back up 10 feet. Walk around in a circle a little bit. Go behind them. Take a few more. I mean, you can take your time with it, dude.
Pile on,
put
dog.
On the fucking well, the
on,
reservoir
dude.
Dogs.
Pile. Here I look in the middle with you.
So do that.
I'm taking back. Oh, my dick.
I love that. Jump to the right. Here I am.
If they would pay me to do it, I would call it a job with almost zero risk. You want me to kill zombies for 8 hours a day in more fun, inventive, crazy ways?
Yeah.
And then I get to go, you're going to pay me a bunch of money? Come on.
And then you get eight the third day.
Apocalypse rich, dude.
All right, I'll give you Walking Dead zombies you could fuck with, but 28 days later zombies?
You're having a problem.
That's a wrap. One kills me.
That's a problem.
Well, a fat one. One fat one kills me.
Gotcha.
If he can run, eventually I will gas, and he's mindless. He doesn't gas. He doesn't gas.
Yeah, he doesn't need lungs.
I hope to God he trips.
Even if he does.
I pick my battles in 28 Days Later Zombies.
28 Days Later Zombies, you got to understand, they have a closing speed unlike any other zombie. If we're doing a...
They take bad
what's
angles,
that?
Though.
World War Z, that's...
I was going to say, World War Z and...
They're a problem.
And what's fucking...
they're a big problem.
World War Z and I Am Legend...
I Am Legend zombies, get out of here. Those are that's Florida wide receiver speed.
Yeah.
That's fucking
Santana Moss.
Yeah, you're gonna I'll tell you what you're getting right there. You're getting a guy that does kick returns, runs the ball. You can do a lot of dude, I Am Legend, you can end around with I Am Legend for days.
I mean, a Columbine sweetheart.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
I was gonna say, geez, I don't get
Columbine
that reference.
That was two different things.
Yeah, but Walking Dead zombies, I see what you mean. You're cleaning, you're walking through that weight division until you gas.
There's no gassing. What's the gassing of putting your arm out? At your pace. The pace you choose. Hey, I'm going to kill 17 and I'm going to go inside. I'm going to smoke a butt, I'm going to regroup, I'm going to have a sandwich, I'll let them pile up again. And I'll go out there and start fucking kebabbing.
Dude, it's so funny, you're going out for your midday shift.
I'm going to start seeing how many I can get in one shot.
Yeah, I'm going to come back in and play another game of 2K, but I think I'm going to go clear the lawn of some Z's. I would want to be the guy that puts in the earbuds of classical music, you know? Yeah. At the end of Beethoven, I'll come in. I got size like Raphael.
And I go, watch him go, Shane. He's like an artist with that sword.
What, would you just be listening to NFL speeches?
you just listen
to Rudy? Just the audio of Rudy?
Every time I come, I'm like, who's the wild man now?
Yeah, wild man. Who's the wild man?
And Rock's always behind you going, yes,
yes,
yes. TV's Rock, Charles S. Dutton.
Nah, I'd go zombie. I'd join him. It's a pretty chill-ass time.
Just give in?
Yeah, but like, what do we do? Just stand?
You put your arm out? You put your arm out?
You fucking idiots?
Hey, you put your arm out like a falconer? Yeah. You go, go. Do me.
Do it.
Do me.
I'll tell you what.
I want to be mostly like, I want to be you, but not like a lot you. So just like.
Yeah. I certainly wouldn't be. I certainly wouldn't do it, but I think. You would say, you know, everybody does in the shows. They go, don't let me become one of those things, man. If I was sitting there dying, I'd go,
I'm gonna see how this goes.
What it is.
I would absolutely.
I'm like, keep me in a cage for like a day, and then, you know, if it's not working out, kill me.
I would absolutely use it in a personal argument where I'd be like this. Oh, fuck, you take such advantage of me. When I'm a zombie, I'm going to eat your ass. Put me down.
I'm coming back.
Put me down. Because the first person I'm going to chew on is your dumb ass. I'm going to come and fucking snack up on you, you fucking prick.
Whatever you kill me with, it better be across the head on that brain thing or whatever that happens.
Yeah.
And end it quick.
Yeah. You better understand that if I fucking pop back up as a zombie,
teeth
you have
knuckles
a,
right at your face.
You have a rhinoceros-like head coming right at you.
Coming through the door.
Yeah. Poof. It's Dan. He's back. I'm just doing the fucking dead man fucking, you know, like Night of the Living Dead kind of thing. I'm just like, I'm the battering ram.
Christine, should we, we're not going to make it out of here.
Do you guys kill each other?
Should we? No. Should we strap? That's what I was saying. We'll strap ourselves to a bed and kill ourselves, and then we'll just be always there just zombieing to each other.
Oh, because we're zombieing at the same time. It's like, guys, it's hard to talk to you when you're zombieing at the same time.
Both zombie at the same time.
Shane and I are there in like cool like cowboy hats. I'm like, can we kill him? And you're like,
yeah, let's dress like idiots and then just fucking zombie each other the rest of our lives.
And then I'm like, I think what we do is we record a podcast for zombies, and we get paid in oil.
One person has to stay human to work the Zoom.
That's
the Zoom recorder.
Yeah, lose even a zombie, but I'm still there, just being like, hey guys, ready?
Christine left. No, where are you going?
Stop trying to bite me. Stop trying to bite me. That was the best part. That's my favorite part.
Brains.
That was my favorite part of Shaun of the Dead. It was at the end, Steve, where he goes in the shed and he's playing video games with his zombie friend.
Yeah.
It's nice. Yeah. That might be my favorite zombie movie.
I love that movie. Yes.
Shaun of the Dead.
Yeah?
Might be my favorite.
I'm Shaun of the Dead in 28 Days Later, but Shaun of the Dead.
Tell you what, I really enjoyed the remake of Dawn of the Dead.
Can I?
Ving Rhames and the thing was pretty good. I feel
really safe right now. Can I be honest?
Be honest.
I've never seen 28 Days Later.
I never made it all the way through.
Oh, it's cool.
Too much accent. I quit, even with zombies.
Do you want to watch it with me? Come
maybe.
On, bud.
I heard the second part stunk.
You know,
the second half of it?
No, the
second one? Movie. Yeah. Yeah, there's two more.
Oh, right.
And they're both fair to Midland.
But 28 Days is a good one to watch?
I like 28 Days Later, yeah.
All right.
It's a lot of fucking...
Do we rewatch The Sopranos?
English zombies.
I don't like to eat your skin. Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
Brains, it is, I were.
Oh, look at the brains on this one.
I want to eat your brains. I knew I did.
I like to eat brains.
It was annoying.
It's so tasty. Yeah.
I always think whenever we do those shitty accents, I always imagine someone in the UK that's like, well, hello, cowboy.
Yeah.
Do you want to play some baseball?
I want to walk
what
on the
up,
sidewalk.
What is up, homie?
Hey.
Hello, homie.
Oh, that is so lit. I mean, that's literally how they sound.
Moronic.
Literally sound like idiots.
It's spot on, isn't it?
Hey there, cowboy.
It's spot on, isn't it?
Spot on,
isn't it?
They're a bunch of wankers. Hello, I have a gun that I won't let go of.
I actually...
Silly beavers.
Silly. Oh, you know what they are? They're a bunch of sleepy Charlies. They're a bunch of dizzy Jeffs.
A bunch of fuzzy Phillips, they are, they is.
They're a bunch of groggy Wallaces.
Oh, you're a real sneaky Leonard, aren't you?
Oh, yes, you are, aren't you?
That was one of my favorite things we ever did.
Yeah, that was their term for gay. He's a little
I was there for that. That was one of the first episodes I did.
Huh?
Yeah, we were making fun of that music.
He's
video.
A bit of a chapped Boris, yes?
Oh, yeah. A little bit of a frazzled Daniel.
He's an autistic Charles.
Yeah. That means he'll suck it. Yeah, stop. That's a brain disorder.
Man,
see how we brought it around? We brought it all the way back to let you know, Shane. You've been exiled back to Harrisburg.
I'm back to Harrisburg? Why?
You have to. It's a trade we've made.
It's Walking Dead out there, man.
Who'd you trade me for?
We can't have you here in our village.
Justin.
We don't have enough rations.
Justin Silver is from Harrisburg?
Yeah, he moved there. He was in the... Dude, we gotta send you there.
I gotta go back to fucking Harrisburg.
Yeah.
Bird.
Whatever, dude. I'm going back to Bobby Ray Hall Honda. Shout out Mechanicsburg. I'm going back to sell Hondas.
Dude, I bet you were
Hondas
awesome
the
selling
shit.
Hondas.
Yeah, dude. I'm just saying.
You
like,
sold cars.
Yeah, I sold cars.
Really?
Yeah.
New?
Brand new Hondas, baby.
How long
did you like to move more? Civics? Civics or Accords?
Accords. I like the Accords a lot.
Accords
better.
Are a great sell.
CRVs are great.
Good car.
If you buy a Fit, you're an obese woman.
If you buy a CRV,
if you buy a Honda Element, you are autistic.
It's not called Fit for Fitness. It's called because it's telling you you will fit.
Is only fat weird ladies.
It is true though.
You'll fit.
CRVs,
like you'll fitness.
CRVs go exclusively to restaurant managers.
CRVs,
creepy
big,
dudes that make the schedule at restaurants.
It should be called the Honda One Size Fits All.
Honda Odyssey.
That wouldn't look cool across the front.
Well, Honda's also Japanese, so they have to be respectful to the large people.
Also, Honda Odyssey, you are an Indian family that is haggling me for 12 hours.
Really?
Yes.
Working
with their kids.
Boy, they love haggling.
I'm like, listen, dude, this is the fucking price.
I'm going to wake up today and go bother this big white man.
Our business here is done. And I'm like, okay, you can leave. Like every time they'd be
your
like, all right, then I'll sit back down. Everybody
out there.
Everybody has moves where they're like, all right. And then you stand up from the table and pretend you're going to leave. Every time they'd stand up, I'd be like, all right, thanks. Yeah, that's it.
And he goes,
I don't give a fuck.
Wait, maybe I was being a bit hasty.
I'm sorry. Yeah. Shane, please forgive me.
Mr. Shane.
Do you mind if my children bring weird foreign smells into all of your cars?
Yeah. Do you want to guess if we are eating this or merely using this for your disadvantage in the negotiation process?
My children are sweating spices the likes of which you have never heard.
Please come in here and pop off those plastic tops so Mr. Shane can smell what a good deal smells
really
like.
Really get those armpits into the fabrics.
I want to walk away with the Odyssey for $22,000 and I cap the food.
The longer you're, the more your office will smell like it was in the Silk Road.
You want to? Hang on. We have to bring in our pet goat. We can't leave him out in the sun.
Dude, that's got to be.
I trust you are animal friendly here. He's my therapy
Look,
goat.
I'm going to say, I'm going to be honest with you guys. This is some. This is kind of racist. But I was working at a car dealership in Mechanicsburg. So. But you see an Indian family rolling in on the lot, those salesmen scatter.
Do they
you
really?
Are. If you're stuck with
what
an
do you guys
Indian
want?
Dude,
you guys want a fat white lady or a fat white
dude?
Yeah,
a lady's good.
Or
I mean,
a fat white
hot
guy?
Chick. If it's a hot chick, the whole fucking gang is out there. Oh, trying to. Yeah. It's so annoying.
Dude, it'd be so great.
It bothered me so much.
Just the second
if a hot chick,
high heels hit that fucking concrete.
Yeah. Bunch of. Yeah. Dudes with fucking spiked, gelled hair come running out.
Oh.
What?
Okay. You got 5 minutes.
You got fucking.
You're
five.
The one who has five. Chill out.
You're the one who has five fucking. Don't look at me. Don't be mad at me. They're the ones who they're saying it too.
Christine, you didn't find my very sweet my idea for our apocalypse. Strapped to a bed, dressed ridiculous, zombieing to each other.
When we come in, when me and Dan come in as zombie killers, I will. I want you, to, Jay. Look at me. I want you to know while you're strapped to the bed, zombie, and I'll fucking slap you. I will.
I
slap
think better
you.
You should tickle him, make him zombie.
That's how
piss.
I get zombie.
Fart
in
your face with make him zombie piss.
I try to slap him, he nips me. Yeah. He gets me.
That's
like,
the way you tickle me to make me.
Like, what happened?
Piss.
I'm like, nothing.
Nothing. It's fine.
Yeah. I hope someone. I hope people heard that clean and say he would tickle me. And he
yeah.
said that.
When I said, yeah, I said you zombie pee.
I'm angry.
I go, Shane, don't get the zombie piss on you. You'll turn into a zombie.
Humiliated.
He's learning.
And then Christine's like, and you go, guys, we can save him.
My duvet.
But then our leader, Francois, I go out to tell him.
We have a hot leader named Francois?
Yeah, dude. He's just piping. All our ladies.
Whose ladies?
And then we kill
your ladies, dude.
I'll cut his fucking head off.
Yeah. You think you will, but Francois is the baddest ass. That's
nah,
why he's
I mean,
a leader.
No, we're shut up, dude.
True
you're a zombie.
True
stay
alpha
out
dog.
Of this, dude.
I'm a zombie.
Zombie.
I fucking fuck. I go, I'm going to spend eternity zombie with
Christine. I just left slapping you, dude. I'm going out to fuck Francois.
It's inconsequential now, man.
Francois leads our group, though. He leads the resistance.
I have all I need in the world. Zombie love.
It's true.
Not a lot of zombies find love, dude. I've forced myself to. We will eventually have to zombie
most
together.
Most zombies are lonely, boys.
We will zombie at each other at first, but eventually we will zombie together. If you believe in any kind of evolution, eventually we will adapt.
Jay's going to hate Christine's zombie noise. She's going, he's going,
I'll give you this quick thing before we go. Me and Shane were playing 2K earlier.
Yeah.
And when Christine kept coming out here and like talking to us while we were playing, and when she would come out here, like Shane went on a run in one of the games,
yeah,
I go... Her voice, it's like nails on a chalkboard to me, dude. You know that. Stop keeping her talking. And then Christine went in the room, and Shane just kept going. He goes, Christine, what was that thing you were saying? He's being so obvious. He goes, that last thing was super interesting. What were you saying?
She was in another room.
And I'm like, oh, man.
She was in that room.
And he goes, no, seriously, Christine, keep going. Say more about it. And she just did. Like she just responded.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
You know what? In that my room. Favorite thing going on, Christine, she has never failed me once on this.
Yeah.
I used to do it a lot when we argued more, which is, I guess, nice to say.
Yeah.
But... It was so funny. It was I used to make a decision at some point in an argument. I go, I'm just going to not respond to anything she says. I wonder how long she'll keep talking. And I used to do it. I used to have my class, and then I would just hold up and I'd go like things like 41 minutes. I mean, like over an hour several times.
What?
Several times over an hour.
What?
I believe it.
And I would just go,
you're all offense.
I swear to God.
In that, Dan,
there was 100 times she went, she goes, and so you think that's okay to say that to me? You think that's okay? It's just, it's like you start going on and on, and you're like, she was asking me a question, I don't answer, and she doesn't miss a beat.
Yeah,
she goes,
Christine's like one of those.
She just goes, room for answer, because she wasn't going to listen to anything I said anyway, and then just continue on with her thing.
Christine's like one of those NBA teams that has to score 130 points just to fucking be in the game.
I can't believe, dude, I'll tell you something Christine's never said to me in her whole life. She's never gone, say something. She'll just keep going.
Well, now you
eventually,
know.
I can't listen anymore, and I just go, not a record, but still pretty good for a Tuesday.
I feel like it's impressive.
I hold the counter up to her.
I feel like Damn. You've adapted, and you know her fighting style now. So you let her punch out, and then when you step in with the time, you have her zapped.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And then she's like done talking. She's like, I said everything I need to say. And Jay's like, wait. He starts rocking her with logic.
And then I start picking her apart with logic. I go, well, here's why everything you just said, because you went on a thoughtless, not thought out at all rant here's all the things I've been thinking about for 40 fucking minutes. What if, and they're all very concise, and it's going to make you look stupid in every possible way.
Yeah, it's like, hey, let's put a pin in this and go back to minute 23, where you said some crazy shit.
Yeah.
After this, we're going to go to 38.
Now, I want to reference minute 7, which was brought up at minute 18. It'd be funny if you walked into Christine in the guest room and she's training herself with a stopwatch. And she's like, it's just really sometimes I feel like you're not listening to what I'm saying, but then sometimes you are. Click. 1, 2, 3, 4. Listen. Go back. Okay, now what I was saying. She's practicing her steps, getting better at arguing you.
She goes, head nod.
Head nod.
Head nod.
Look at him. Look at him. Head nod.
Cry. Cry. I'm winning. Cry. Now I'm winning.
Turn the tides. Turn it on, Evans. Turn it on.
If you start crying, it's over.
She does that video.
Waterworks!
She does that video, you know, of like she has to play the thing to ramp her up. It's like all of her different childhood memories ramping up. And she's like meditating in the other room.
Dude, it's too bad. Dude, if, you know what's funny? If a girl starts crying in an argument and then you counter with the cry back... She's just instantly like, oh, you're a pussy. Oh, yeah. Oh, we're breaking up.
Oh, she goes, you know what?
Have you cried back at a chick?
Not during a fight. That's hilarious.
Oh, man.
I might start trying.
Dude, I'll try that.
She goes, I can't believe it's in me. He goes, I can't believe it's in me.
She goes, what are you doing? And you go, what are you doing?
I can't believe I didn't make that reservation.
I think a woman respects you more if you go, believe it, bitch.
Not I can't believe you said it to me. Well, believe it. This is how bad it could get.
Bro, try that with tears in your eyes.
No, believe it.
Rage tears?
Believe it, you bitch. I'll fucking kill you. I'll kill myself. I'm going to call the cops. I think mine seems much more like huff and puffy, like winning the
Guys, try this.
Like,
yeah, you got to try it.
It sounds like you're plotting a long game.
Well, I'm crying and just being like... Believe it.
No, but you gotta say believe it.
You better believe it.
This is like our Let's Get Dangerous, but it's for
it might be the last thing you ever believe.
You gotta go like this. If you want to do it, sad sack of shit, you go like,
better believe it.
And then she's like, stop. Please stop. And
you're like, I'm gonna kill you, bitch.
I love you.
I love you. I'll kill you.
I love you.
I swear to God, I'll murder your whole family.
I'm gonna throw up,
and then I'm gonna drive to your mom's.
You
cut so her much, fucking head off.
Kill your father. You gotta do the chunk cry from Goonies. And then I said I was gonna leave you, but I wasn't gonna leave you.
And I picked out, and they kicked me out.
I hope Lou edits in the Rocky 3 cry is still the best. The Rocky 3 when
play it, Lou.
He dies. It's guttural.
Straight guttural. Shane M. Gillis.
And then like, fades in the funeral.
Yeah. Oh, I guarantee Lou's playing it right now.
Melech Olam, Baruch Ata, Tenoi, Adonai, Melech Olam, Hashem.
They are called Yisrael.
At Shane M. Gillis.
Yes.
Guys, he did the Jewish prayer at the funeral. I feel like he got the reference.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Rocky did a Jewish prayer.
Yeah, I know.
Mickey's.
Wait, Mickey was Mickey's Jew?
Jewish.
Yes.
I'm on Mr. T's side.
That was a real surprise.
Mr. T's doing the Lord's work. He's like, get this old Jew out of here.
You know what I'm doing? I'm cleaning up.
Get the Florida, motherfucker.
I'm new book. You old book. You out.
I smell Jew in here.
I'm the New Testament. You ain't the real Testament. I'm the real Testament.
What's this Jew doing a bathrobe back here?
I don't like it. I don't like an Italian being coached by a Jew. I don't like it.
I'm sorry I interrupted you, buddy.
I was plugging Shane.
No,
Shane.
I know.
Yeah.
At Shane M. Gillis, ShaneGillis.com.
Yeah, sure. Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast.
Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast.
BigJ.com. Rochester, New York. Comedy at the Carlson. That is June 6th through the 8th.
Tampa is Side Splitters.
Tampa
Improv. Fuck.
Tampa Improv.
Tampa Bay. June 6th through the 8th. Shane Gillis and Big J.